Hey everybody, this is a quick look at just the physical items that come with the LEGO Dimensions Midway Arcade Level Pack. The figure is called Gaming Kid, and his exclusive printed toy tag piece is pretty cool looking with a little bit of a circuit board motif. Gaming Kid himself has the Midway Defender Alien Lander print on his green t-shirt underneath, and he comes with actually two of those printed coin pieces. So one is a spare, so he can always play his arcades, and he also includes a can of soda, and that has a printed piece on the top, which is an existing part. Very nice to get, though. There is a spare of that included as well, but there's no print on the cylinder. He does get a print on the back of the torso, which does show through just a little bit of the green t-shirt underneath, so it shows that his jacket that he's wearing is pretty short. With the hair off, there's a clearer look at his face. I'm assuming him and Video Game Guy from Series 12 collectible minifigures will do a collaboration someday. The Defender cabinet is pretty cool, and it has only printed pieces, no stickers. So the side art is printed, the logo up above is printed, and the screen that's actually showing the game being played is also printed. On the front of the machine are two studs with holes in them, so they just stuck a microphone piece through one of those to represent a joystick. This thing is pretty cool looking. It's strange that they chose green for the color of the cabinet. I think that most of these cabinets were black as kind of the signature color of it, but what bugs me just a little bit more is the obviousness of the light gray colored pieces that show through. But it's still really cool to get these pieces, and worst case scenario, you can do a little bit of customization, a little bit of part substitution, and make this look even better. The in-game build, as far as I could tell, is absolutely identical, but this is not something that acts as a vehicle like many of the builds do. This is just something that works in conjunction with an arcade dock for certain unlocks. The first rebuild, called the 8-bit shooter, is something that you can actually ride around on, and it can actually shoot and it flies. The second rebuild is pretty cool in that it's just so different. You have to consider that this uses all of the pieces of the original arcade cabinet build, so that makes that build look much better when you consider how far they can change it. But this is basically just a ground turret. The second build represents the car from Spy Hunter, another classic arcade game, and that was one that I really, really loved. I was never able to play it quite as much as I wanted to, but this is a good representation of that car, its overall shaping. Of course, in-game, in the original real arcade game, you would see it more from the top, so I guess this is more the view that you'd be looking for. Notice it is missing the red stripes. That's unfortunate. I wish that they had printed those on, but it's, like I said, pretty recognizable in general. A nice, well-done build, you know, just as a LEGO thing, a well-done build with a small parts count, and it does use two of those stud pieces with holes in them in light gray, and those are still very difficult to come by, and they also include even a spare of those, so you get a total of three of those in this set. And of course, it is LEGO Dimensions. It's not one of the other toy to life game setups, so you actually can take the thing off. It's made of just regular LEGO pieces, and you can roll it around and use it as a real toy, and you can still save the data on just the toy tag itself, so you can keep these separate. In LEGO Dimensions, the car is identical looking, although they do have to kind of cheat a little bit in order to fit a person in there. The first level of upgrade turns it into a submarine. That's a pretty good use of those parts. And then the second upgrade turns it into an airplane. Now, all three of these things move very slowly relative to what they are, so the car is a very slow car. The submarine is okay. The airplane is very slow, but this is nice uses of those exact same parts to really change things up. This gives you a lot of variety. I will definitely do some part color substitutions on one of these arcade cabinets, but I really like the stuff that comes with this pack. It's definitely one of my favorite of the LEGO Dimensions add-on packs so far for the physical things, for the actual toys. The figure is very collectible, and the prints that come with the arcade cabinet are just golden to me. Cool car too, and some cool pieces. Let me know what you think about this one, share your thoughts in the comments, and I'll talk to you again soon.